Now let's see about a polygon. What is a polygon? It is a closed figure made up of only line segments. Okay, the important keywords for a polygon is it should be a closed figure and it should be made up of only line segments. So if you want to identify whether the given figure is a polygon or not, you need to see, you need to check that is it a closed figure and is it made up of only line segments, then yes. Suppose here if I draw this figure, then check it out whether it is a closed figure, then yes. Is it made up of only line segments? Yes. Both the conditions are satisfied. So yes, this is a polygon. If I say that is this a polygon, then here you can say that it is a closed figure, yes, but it is not made up of only line segment. This is a line segment but this is a curve, which is not a line segment. So this is not a polygon. If you are asked that is this a polygon, then yes, it is a closed figure and made up of only line segments. So yes, this is a polygon. This is also a polygon, right? So both the conditions should be satisfied. Now, I want to try it out whether I am able to form a polygon using 5 sticks, 4 sticks, 3 sticks and 2 sticks. I want to try it out. Here you can see I have the sticks over here, 3 and 2, 5. 5 sticks are there. I am trying to make a polygon using 5 sticks. So here, let me try it out. So here, 3 and 2 more. I need to join them. So I tried to make a closed figure using 5 sticks. You can also try it out on your own. You can form it like this. You can make it like this. You can make the way you want. Okay. The thing is that you have to try to make a closed figure using 5 sticks. So yes, here you can see that I am able to form a closed figure using 5 sticks. So yes, with 5 sticks polygon is possible, and the polygon with 5 sides is known as a pentagon. Okay, now I will try to form a closed figure using 4 sticks. So I am going to remove one of the sticks. So here I remove one stick and now I am left out with 4 sticks, and here you can see that I am able to form a closed figure. Okay, you can make like this, you can make like this, the way you want. It should be a closed figure. Yes, so polygon with 4 sides is also possible, and it's known as quadrilateral. Polygon with 4 sides is known as quadrilateral. Now, I want to try with 3 sticks, is it possible or not. So, one still I remove it. So now what I have it. Now one I have removed. Now I am left out with 3 sticks. And yes, here you can see that polygon with 3 sides is also possible. And which is this shape? This is a triangle. So polygon with 3 sides is a triangle. And now I remove one more. So here I am left out with two sticks, and now I am trying to make a closed figure. Am I able to? No. So with 2 sticks, polygon is not possible. Okay. Polygon with 2 sides is not possible. It means polygon with least number of sides is a triangle. Now, what is a regular polygon? Regular polygon means it is a polygon with all the 3 sides or any number of sides the polygon is, they should be of equal measurement and the angles also should be equiangular. That is equiangular also. So if the sides and angles of a polygon are equal, then it is said to be a regular polygon. Say here you have a hexagon. If all the six sides of the hexagon are equal, then we will say that it is a regular hexagon. If the figure is shown like this, then here you can see that these two sides are equal, but they are not equal to these sides. So this is not a regular polygon, but yes, this is a regular polygon because all the six sides are equal and all the six angles also are equal. So equiangular also and equal sides also. Check each of the shape in the given figure. Let's start with the top figure. It has six vertices, six sides, six angles. It's a hexagon. This is a square. All four sides are equal. These two are parallelogram. This is a trapezium. These two are also parallelogram. Check each of the shapes in this figure now. Here these are all squares. These are all triangles. This is a parallelogram. Right? Have you seen any common point in this figure? Yes, this was a closed figure. This is also a closed figure. This is also a closed figure. They are all made up of line segments. Right? It has three line segments. Square has four line segments. Parallelogram has four line segments. Right? Let us see few paper folding activities for polygons. You may be surprised that we often tie knots in pajama strings and length of the rope, seldom noticing that a tight knot takes the shape of the pentagon. Let's try it out. I will show you when you fold the rectangular strip of paper and tie the two loose ends into an ordinary knot. And what happens here? See, this is the ordinary rectangular strip of paper and I tie it an ordinary knot. The two ends, I just gently pull it. And see this one. It has taken a shape of a pentagon. Here you can see that. Is it? You may also try the same. Enjoy maths. Maths is just the enjoyment. Now let us see how to make concentric hexagon. Okay, so take a piece of paper, fold it into half, then make 60 degree angle by paper folding activity as you know, and then go on pressing like this, first crease, then second crease, and then third crease. You can make still more and open it, and you will see that concentric hexagon is being made. Is it okay? Draw the lines on the opposite side so that it's clear also. Once again, just see that. Fold the paper into half. Mark the center point by folding it and then make 60 degree angle and then go on folding. First crease, then second, and then third. You can make fourth also and then just open it. And you will see that regular hexagon is made. And the other lines also you can see. So ultimately regular concentric hexagons are being made. Now we will see how to define sides, vertices and diagonals of a polygon and how to represent them in mathematical language. So here first we start with sides. What is a side of a polygon? That is, the line segments forming a polygon are called its side, line segments. So consider this diagram. So here how many sides it has, let us see. Here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 5 sides it has. So here which are the 5 sides here? So I can write it as line segment AB, first line segment BC, line segment CD, line segment DE, line segment EA. Remember that line segment AB is one and the same as line segment BA also. So if somebody has written line segment CB or line segment DC or line segment ED or line segment EA, then also it's correct. So 5 sides are this one. Say you are given a triangle. So which are the 3 sides of a triangle? That is PQ, line segment QR and line segment PR. These are the sides. Remember to write the line segment correctly. Say you are given a quadrilateral. I am writing say X, Y, Z, P. So here which are the sides of this quadrilateral? Line segment XY, line segment YZ, line segment PZ, line segment PX. So these are the sides. So what are the sides? The line segments forming a polygon are called its sides. Now we will see adjacent sides. Now what is adjacent side? Adjacent sides means any two sides with a common endpoint. They are called adjacent sides. Suppose you have this figure given and I am talking about these two line segments, that is AB and AE. AB line segment and AE line segment, that these two sides have the common endpoint. So these are called adjacent sides. Two sides with a common vertex or common endpoint, they are called adjacent sides. Suppose I want to find out the adjacent sides of BC, then BC and which else is the adjacent side? So BC, if you are going this way, then BC and BA are adjacent sides, or you can say that BC and CD also are the adjacent sides, because here you have C as the common vertex and in this two B is the common vertex. But you cannot say that AB and ED, suppose you are writing say AB and ED, then do they have any common vertex? No. So they are not adjacent sides. Is it okay? Not adjacent sides. So adjacent sides should have one common endpoint. Now we will see vertex. What is a vertex? The meeting point of a pair of adjacent sides is called a vertex. And vertices is a plural of vertex. So if I say this is the figure given here and I have written here A, B and C, I have labeled the triangle as ABC. A, B and C, these are the 3 vertices of this triangle. So how many vertices it has? 3 vertices, A, B and C. These are the 3 vertices of a triangle ABC. If you have the figure given over here, say A, B, C and D, then, or let me consider as say P, Q, R, S, then vertices of this figure are, you have it as P, Q, R and S. That is, these two are the adjacent sides and this is the meeting point of these two sides. So, meeting point of a pair of adjacent sides is called a vertex. Meeting point of a pair of adjacent sides. So, these two are adjacent sides and this is the meeting point. These two are the adjacent sides and this is the meeting point. Similarly, here also and similarly here also. So, they are all vertices. In a pentagon, how many vertices are there? Or in a hexagon, how many are there? So, here, these are the five vertices in a pentagon. And here, these are the vertices in a hexagon. Now, let's see very, very important concept of a diagonal in a polygon. What is a diagonal in a polygon? The line segments joining any two non-adjacent vertices of a polygon are its diagonal. Very easy for a quadrilateral. Remember that quadrilateral has four sides. So, if this is a quadrilateral, say ABCD, then if I am talking about this vertex, that is D vertex, then DC and DA are the adjacent sides, right? So, what are the two non-adjacent vertices? With D, C and E, A are the adjacent vertices. So, which is the non-adjacent? B is the non-adjacent vertice. So, line segment joining two non-adjacent vertices. So, you need to join this two. Similarly, you need to join A and C. So, AC and BD are the diagonals in a quadrilateral. Okay. If you have the figure, say a pentagon or a hexagon, then we will find out how many diagonals it has. Let's start with hexagon. You start with this vertex, suppose. So, I start with joining this 1, 2, 3 plus. Now, I come to this point. I can join this 1, 2 and 3. Now I come to this point. I can join 1 and 2. Now I come to this point. I can join this one. These two are already joined. So only one. So it has 9 diagonals. Okay. Now always you cannot go on drawing the diagonals and find out how many diagonals are there in a polygon. There may be some formula to find out the number of diagonals in a polygon. So, what is that formula? That is n into n minus 3 upon 2. What is this n? That is number of sides in a polygon. So, if I am talking about a pentagon, then how many diagonals it has? Let's join here 1, 2. So, 2 plus I come to this point and I join the diagonals. So, 2. I come to this point. I can join only 1. So, here I have 1. 2 plus 2 plus 1. That is 5. 5 diagonals in a pentagon. 9 diagonals in a hexagon. Let's verify for this pentagon. So, here you will have 5. Into 5 minus 3, that is 2 upon 2. So, 2 will go away, so 5. And here also you have checked by drawing the diagonals. For this one, you can substitute the values as 6. And 6 minus 3 is 3 upon 2. So, 2 3s are 6, so 3 3s are 9. And you have verified here also. Is it okay? So, what is the formula for finding the diagonals in a polygon? N into n minus 3 upon 2, and n is the number of sides.